My niggas and my niggettes, you know what time it is. It's time for a motherfucking blog. And I gotta gather my thoughts for this one. Because I was reading this article, and this shit, it damn near scared me, knowing how close the music industry works with the prison system. Again, the music industry is in cahoots with the prison system. So do you know what that means? That means that it's not just a coincidence that these music labels and these motherfuckers are going out to get these motherfuckers like Bobby Shmurda, Tekashi 6ix9ine, NBA Youngboy, YM whatever, Melly, whatever that dude's name is. It's not a coincidence that they are strategically getting these guys. You know why they're getting these guys? Again, because of the message that they put out in their music. All right, so when you have these labels and these big like media companies working with the prison system, what it is it's like one hand wash the other. It's like, all right, we're gonna need you to get these artists, right? Because of, and hold on, before I get sidetracked, I gotta say this again. Music, especially hip hop music, is the most influential genre of music. They know how potent and effective the messages are and how it reaches the kids, all right? Keep that in mind. So, again, one hand washes the other. So what these motherfuckers do is, they say, all right, we're gonna get a Tekashi 6ix9ine. We're gonna blow him up. We're gonna make him a star. We're gonna make him so big and use his message to basically reach the youth, right? Basically, they're trying to perpetuate more crime. They want more kids out there actively committing crime so they could get locked up and go to jail. And when you have more crime, you have more blacks getting locked up. And what? Prison is big business. We know this, right? We know this. Even Pac said this shit. Prison is big business. So when you have the prison filled with all these blacks and they constantly getting these motherfuckers to go to jail, that means that the prison system is flourishing. It's doing well because we're doing what we're supposed to do. We're having all these blacks locked up. And in return, the media companies that have their shares in these prison systems, they thrive too. So it's like a whole scheme, but you dumb motherfuckers don't want to use your brain. That's why I'm going to leave this article at the bottom so you can look it up for yourself. I mean, just think about it. The fucking medical industry is corrupt as well. Everybody knows goddamn well that there's a cure for a lot of these diseases, whether it's AIDS, cancer. We know there's cures for this shit, but why don't they let us know the cure? Because if they let us know the cures, that means these motherfuckers are gonna be cured of their disease, and they're not gonna be dependent on the medications that obviously these companies are using to make money off them. You know what I'm saying? You can't fucking make money giving your medication out and a motherfucker's cured. You feel what I'm saying? So it's like, it's all fucking corrupt. Whether it's the medical industry or the music industry, nothing is fucking off limits. So this is why I stay my ass in my own lane and I say fuck the music industry, and I'm on some shit like, I don't even know if I want to rap anymore, because at the end of the day, if I get on, my message is fucking a conflict of interest with that shit anyway, because I'm going totally against that shit. And you might say, well, what about artists like Kendrick and J. Cole? Man, you think these motherfuckers care about Kendrick and J. Cole? Their message is not even penetrating the shit in design that these motherfuckers are doing. It's not even coming close. That's why Kendrick and Cole, they can just be left alone. Because they're not affecting the bigger picture. If I got into this motherfucking game and kicked the shit that I want to kick, they would be like, this motherfucker's a threat. He's talking specifically about our whole fucking corrupt operation and putting the world onto it. That's why you can get away with talking about little shit like, yo, black people killing each other in the streets, because it's like, okay, we know this shit. This is what I'm saying, yo. This shit is backwards, bro.